It's Frontier Conference basketball from the opening tip-off to the final buzzer. 12 of the best teams in the NAIA. 6 men, 6 women, all fighting the right to represent at a national tournament. We bring you all the action from the Pacific Steel Four Seasons Arena right here in Great Falls. Our games are brought to you in part by First Interstate Bank, BSN Sports, Pepsi, Nike, the Gibson Hotel in Great Falls, McDonald's throughout the state of Montana, D.A. Davidson, Independence Bank, Logan Health, Confero Sports Foundation, Clark & Lewis, Northwest Energy, and IRC Hotels throughout the state. Hey, if you're ready, it is time. Sit back and enjoy the call as it's time for Frontier Conference basketball, and we're bringing it to you right now.
Ready to unleash your awesome? Then you need 8 gig all-fiber internet from TDS. You'll have the powerful internet you need to stream, game, learn, and work today, and be prepared to take on anything new you can dream up tomorrow. Imagine internet you'll never outgrow. Get 8 gig all-fiber internet from TDS and embrace infinite possibility.
At the University of Providence, we believe college is more than a collection of buildings, or a lecture, or a test, or even a degree. College is about connecting to something greater than yourself. The University of Providence is a private Roman Catholic liberal arts university founded in 1932 by the Sisters of Providence. And we continue to honor their vision by providing students with an education that goes beyond the classroom. An education grounded in our mission of connecting people. Connecting people with their communities, with one another, with the environment, with opportunities, with their spiritual journey. And most importantly, connecting people with their potential. The University of Providence.
For more than 85 years, D.A. Davidson has strived to build relationships and trust. From our first office in Montana to each of our 70 locations spread out coast to coast, we're on the ground and in your neighborhood, combining the values of a local partner with the capabilities of a national institution. We achieve strong outcomes based on mutual success, planning for future generations and building legacies that endure together.
Passion. It's what drives us. When you get your hands on something that you're passionate about, there's nothing else like it. That's the value of hands-on learning. So whether your passion is painting or plumbing, engines or engineering, if you're ready to turn your passion into a profession, find us at MSU Northern.
Who's it going to be? Is it going to be the Argos? Is it going to be the Saints. We're going to find out here. The game's going to start here in just a few minutes. We're running just a little bit behind schedule, but they still have some. They give out the an award here for a sportsmanship award. It's a champion of character, they call it, and they give it out. Each coach votes for one player off of his team to win this award, and it's a big award to give them. That's coaches are figuring out it's all about sportsmanship, community service, a lot of good things that go into it. The winners of these, they should be proud of themselves. It's a huge award for the Frontier Conference. And they give one out to each team. And neither of these teams played yesterday, so out there to give the award. That's going to be your conference commissioner. His name is Scott Campbell. He's new this year as well. He's living up in Whitefish, I think, is where he comes out of for this tournament. And he's going to name out who our winners are. Now, I have my headphones on, so I have a hard time hearing who it is. And they're all still wearing their uniform or their warm-ups. So we'll have to pay attention to see who these guys are. Big award. And we're looking at, of course, the Argos are wearing.
Semifinal action on a Friday afternoon. Who will play for the Frontier Conference Tournament Championship tomorrow? Will it be the University of Providence Argos?
No.
Or will it be the Carroll College Fighting Saints? But first, ladies and gentlemen, a little bit of business to take care of. Please focus your attention on the court as we take a moment to recognize a champion of character featuring a student from Carroll College. Representing Carroll College and selected by head coach Ryan Lundgren, James Lang. Says Coach Lundgren, James defines what it means to be a winner both on and off the court, maintaining a very high standard on both the court and in the classroom. James is a great ambassador of both our basketball program and Carroll College as a whole. Congratulations, James Lang, our champion of character. Let's get ready to meet our athletes.
Let's go ahead and do the roster. I know what's going on there, and we're going to go ahead and start with the Argos because they are the visiting team here. And Coach J.C. Eisenton, he's in his first year. He used to play for Western in this conference, in this league, and he's going to be at helm now for the Argos. He's going to start number one. That's Jalen Reed. Jalen is a guard. He's 6'5". He's a senior out of Lodi, Washington. He's also going to start number four. That's going to be Davian Harris-Williams. He's a guard. He's a six-footer. He's a senior out of Tacoma, Washington, and the go-getter for this ball club. They rally around him. He's going to start out there, number 23. That's going to be Javon Burton. Javon, he's a forward. He's 6'5". He's a senior, and he's out of Houston, Texas. Fourth starter's going to run out there, though. He's a local boy, and wearing number 24, and Sam Vining. He's a guard. He's 6'2". He's a senior. Played for Sam Russell High School right here in Great Falls. As this is the next starter, we're number 33. That's Jake Olson. He's a, they list him as a forward. He's 6'5". He's a senior, and he's out of Sam Russell High School as well. So a little local flavor out there for Coach Isaacson. Two great ball players. I know I don't know if they won state when Jake was there, but they won when Vining was there. His three-point shooting is amazing. It was amazing then. It's amazing now. Here's our starters now. G. Pedra, he's going to start. He's a forward. He's 6'6". He's out of Sao Paulo, Brazil. He's also going to start number 10. That's Ken Lamore. He's a guard. He's 5'11". He's out of Dayton, Ohio. Then he's going to start Andrew Cook. Andrew, he wears number 11. He's a guard. He's 6'4". He's out of Huntington Beach, California. And is quite a ball player, folks. He's going to start a sophomore. That's Derek Kramer. He wears number 20. He's a forward. He's 6'9", and he's out of Bellevue, Washington. And the final starter for Coach Lundgren, he's going to be wearing number 31. That's James Lang, the winner of that citizenship award. He's a guard. He's a six-footer. He's out of Portland, Oregon. The referees are out there. They're ready to go. The teams are all in their huddles and getting ready to get out here on the floor. It's going to be the Argos and the Saints. Nice crowd on hand as we get ready to start this second semifinal. Who's going to play Tech tomorrow at 5 o'clock?
Outside!
Argos are on the floor. Refs are on the floor. Where's Carroll? There they are over the huddle. Last minute instructions. It's going to be Javon Burton. He's going to be jumping center for the Argos. And I'd be surprised if it isn't Derek Kramer jumping for the Saints, and it is. And now they're out there on the floor. Everybody's getting lined up around the circle. Referee's got the ball. He's got the whistle. Everybody's set. We're playing. Ball's in the air. He has him in control by Carroll. Get the ball right in the hands of Kendall. Kendall's going to bring it right forward. Kendall, looking like a little man-to-man defense down on that end of the floor as he goes over the right-hand side. Kicks it out the head of G. That's going to be G. G now gives it to Andrew Cook. Cook gets it inside, trying to work his way back. Derek Kramer coming out of the steal. That's going to be Sam Vining down to the front court. And it's going to be Harris Williams. Harris Williams in the guard by Kendall. Tries to go by him. Goes on the left-hand side. That's going to be Reed. Reed, head of the key to Burton. Burton, and hands it off over to Vining. Vining behind the back dribble. He's in the paint. He's got a little fadeaway shot. He shoots in there. It's up, and it's good. Sam Vining got one of the best fadeaway shots you'll ever see. And here, coming to the front court, is going to be Kendall Moore. And he's guarded out there. That's going to be Burton on him. Burton ran into some foul trouble yesterday. He wants to be careful. They need to keep him on the floor. And now it's Cook in the corner, head of the key. That's going to be in the hands of Pedra. Pedra goes to the inside. Defense by Vining. He has to put up a tough shot. It's no good. Rebound comes off. Vining's got it. He gets the ball to Harris Williams, and Harris Williams in the front court. Moore picks him up right there at the free throw, head of the key. Jake sets a pick. Olsen, far side, Vining. He looks at that three-point shot, takes the paint. He's got that little shot in there. That one's good as well. 4 points already for Vining. He's got all the points for the Argos as they take that 4-0 lead, and now Kendall. Moore's in the front court. Burton's on him. He's going to work over there on the right-hand side of the floor. Trying to set a pick for him. And they just going to slide through the pick. Out there on the floor is Lang now. Lang trying to get the ball to him to go to Pedro at the head of the key. He's looking inside. Nothing there. Nothing there. Now he goes left side. Cook. Cook. Skip pass. Far side. Lang's going to put up a three from the corner. It's off the rim. No good. Rebound comes off. Who's got it? Harris Williams. He's working his way up the far side of the floor. He's in the front court now. Gets picked up there by Moore. Moore gives right by him. Gets it. Jake. Jake's got a layup. All 6 points for the Argos are Sam Russell grads. Vining's got four. Olsen's got two. Up six, up nothing. And in the front court, here comes the Saints. It's going to be Kendall Moore. He plays the point. Trying to get the ball inside. Good defense being played in there. He's got to go to the corner to Pedra. Going back over to Moore. Good defense being played on him. He gets by Reed. He goes into Olsen. Shot's no good. Olsen playing the good defense. Ball gets knocked in the air. Olsen's got it. And he gets the ball in the hands of Burton. Burton's in the front court. Harris Williams deep in the corner. Vining. And they're going to hold things up. No. Reed says, I'm going to take it inside. And has made a big mistake. Coming out of there with it on the steal. Playing the good defense. That's going to be Kramer. Kramer gets the ball to Moore. And they're in the front court. And on the dribble, head of the key, steal Moore, right-hand side. That's Lang. Lang kicks inside. Olsen can't get over him. Pedra, he's going to be ahead of the key. He's going to go back to Lang. He's going to try it again. Still trying to get it over. Still can't get it over Olsen. Coming out of the way, there's going to be Harris Williams. Harris Williams going to slow things down. They're up 6-0 as he brings it in the front court. He's going to set a pick on Moore to free him up. And he stops. He's going to pop a three of his own. That's up and good. Harris Williams, he can't give the guy an inch. They just did. It cost him 3 points. So a 17-01 here to play still in the first half. Argos 9, Saints nothing. So we're going to take a break here in the play as we got a timeout. And let's see if the referee says how long it is. Into the defense and that man-to-man they're playing on this end of the floor. Now they get the ball, hit the key. That's going to be Cook. Cook takes it in the paint. They shut him off there. He's still on the dribble, though, trying to work his way inside. Has to kick it back out to Moore. He's got a three-pointer on the way. It's good. And now Carroll's on the board as Kendall Moore gets a three-pointer. Front court, Harris Williams drops the ball off to Vining. He's going to launch a three from way out there. That's off the front of the rim, no good. Long rebound comes out. Lang's got it. Into the gives it to Moore, and they're back on the offense. Gets the ball to Cook. Cook being guarded by Vining. Goes back to Moore at the head of the key. They're going to try to set a pick to free him up. Jake Olson cuts that thing off. Now they go to Pedra. Back to Moore at the head of the key. You've got Reed on him. He goes down to the baseline. That's where Cook is. Cook with Vining on him. Tries to go baseline. Vining cuts him off. He's still on the dribble, working his way inside. Pedra, he's got a three-pointer from the head of the key. It's no good. Rebound comes off. Reed's got it for the Argos. He's going to bring it to the front court on the far side of the floor. Onto this side to Burton. Burton, he goes right by Pedro. He's in the paint. Little three-pointer fadeaway shot. It's no good. Rebound comes off. Coming out of there with it is going to be Kramer. Kramer gets the ball to Cook, and Cook's in the front court. He hands the ball off to Moore. They're down 9-3. Now he's got Pedro. He's looking inside. There's Cook kicking the corner. Back over to Cook. He's going to launch a three of his own, and that one's good. 6-9 now. They got three-point shooters on both of these squads. And it's Harris Williams on the dribble. He's at the head of the key. They're going to cut him off. He's going to go inside to Olson. Olson with a head fake. He's up. The shot's no good. The rebound comes out. Coming out of there with it's going to be Lang. He's got it. He gets the ball into Moore. He had to look at it. A little two-pointer under the basket. Couldn't get the ball to drop. Olson now is going to play good defense on that on the floor. He has to kick the ball over to Cook. Cook, now they get the ball down on the baseline. That's Kramer. Kramer has to go back to Pedro. Cook in the corner. And we have a whistle-off ball. And somebody was hooking. It's going against Carroll. And it's going to be the first foul of the ball game called on Derek Kramer. First foul of either side. Pretty clean ball game up to this point. There's 15-11 to play here in the first half, so we're about a quarter of the way through the first half before we get our first foul. And now Reed, he's going to bring in the front court. He's going to get the ball to Burton. Burton, he's being guarded by number 25 out there. That's Isaiah Moore. Now they got two Moores on the floor. They get the ball to Harris Williams. A little spin move in the paint. He's up and good. There's just nothing you can do with that guy. He's got a ton of moves and a terrific shot. Nice touch. And now it's 11-6 Argos. And it's going to be Kendall Moore. Gets the ball to Isaiah Moore. Gets the ball inside to Cook. A little spin drop shot. It's up and it's good. And coming out there's going to be Harris Williams. He's got the front court. Reed, he's going to launch a three from the side. It's good. Jalen Reed, what a shot that one was. He was way out there. He was nowhere close to that three-point line. Gives a 14-8 lead, though, for the Argos, but the ball's Kendall Moore. He's dribbling over there with Burton playing the defense. They're going to pick him to get rid of him. Says he gets Olson. Olson, they're going to throw a pass. It's going to go backcourt, and it's going to be over and back. Excellent try by Cook to keep it from going there, but he wasn't quite fast enough. Well, now we have another player on the floor. I'm going to have to get this guy. He's from Istanbul, Turkey. His name is Murat Gozalocic. Always a mouthful. 14-12 to play. Saints up six. Or excuse me, Argos up six. Saints on the defense. Here comes Reed. He's coming across the top of the key. There's Harris Williams. He's going to launch a long three of his own. That one's off the front of the rim. No good. Isaiah Moore gets a rebound to Kendall Moore to Cook, and they're in the front court. Working over here on the left-hand side. You're going to get picked up there by Reed. On the left-hand dribble. He's on the left-hand side. Going down to Murat. He's going to try to work his way inside. He's a big, big man. He got Olson on the ropes, and the ropes up and in. And Guzalocic is how you say that name. He gets the basket. Front court now. It's going to be Harris Williams. Drops the ball off to Reed. Reed getting defense being played by Guzalocic. He gets the ball. He steals it. Gets the ball to Lang. Lang's got a shot in the paint. It's no good. He follows his own shot. And he, instead of rebounding it, he tried to throw it to Isaiah Moore, but he threw it out of bounds. And so at 13:23 to play here in the first half, with the Argos up 14-10, there's going to be a timeout on the floor, probably a media timeout. Let's see what they say. Yeah, everybody's sitting down. We're gone for a minute. KQDI.
Montana. We're proud to say it's where we live and where we work. We're so much more than pretty scenery. We are all hardworking, resilient, and resourceful. The vibe is different here. Stockman Bank, Montana's brand of banking.
Yeah.
How many pages got left?
30.
Break time.
Good looking out.
I got you.
Buy one, get one for a dollar is back. So double up or mix and match. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
The Carroll Saints. Saints always have a nice crowd following. The Argos have a nice crowd on hand as well. We've had nice crowds for all this session. This is such good basketball, folks. You ought to come out and watch it. If you can, just settle back in. We've got them all here on KQDI, 1450, and the Argos have the ball. And up there now is going to be Eric Milner. Eric going to be wearing number 10. He's a 6'3 guard, and he is a senior. And he gets the ball, drops off to Harris Williams. And Harris Williams, he's got another three-pointer on the way from way outside. Going to give Eric an assist on that. He's out of San Bernardino, California. And now here comes Moore to Lang to Cook as they bring Rawl around the perimeter. They're going to set a pick, see if they can free Cook up. Olsen playing the good defense. Now they got him trapped. Good job by Cook. Get rid of that ball. Far side, that's going to be Kendall Moore taking the ball inside. Olsen's in front of him. I think they're going to call a foul on Olsen. Jake gets a lot of fouls in there that sometimes you wonder how that is. He's standing there straight up, and somehow there was contact. Kendall Moore is going to go to the free throw line. First foul of the ball game on the Argos. First one, of course, on Olsen. And Moore goes to the free throw line. Kendall's got this one on the way. It's a nice high arcer. It's good. And now it's a six-point lead. Lang wants to get inside. They're going to move Guzalochik out of there. I'm not sure why. He's a big guy. He must be prone to foul on rebounds. That second one doesn't want to drop, but it does. And now it's a five-point Argo lead. With the ball is going to be Eric Milner bringing in the front court. Gets on this end. Cook's going to pick him up. Gets the ball to Harris Williams. Harris Williams is going to take the ball in the paint. Cook's on him. We're reaching for the ball. Can't quite get it. Harris Williams. I think they're calling for hooking. Foul goes against Harris Williams. He's going to offensive foul. Second foul on the Argos. And it's going to go to Cook. Cook to throw it into Moore. Moore's got Eric right in his face. Milner now forces him over the right-hand side. Gives the ball over to Cook now. Cook takes on the baseline. He's got Burton in front of him. Trying to back his way in there. Now they're going to try to double-team him. They go out. They got a three-pointer. It's on the way. Lang shooting it. Lang's got it. James Lang with a three-point shot. Getting that lead to 2 points. 12-10 to play first half. In the front court's going to be Harris Williams. Moore's going to pick him up there. Olsen to set a pick to try to free him up. There's a pick. Doesn't free him up. Steady goes to Burton, head of the key. Burton turns, looks. He's got Isaiah Moore on him. He goes over to Vining. Vining goes on down towards the baseline. Gets the ball inside to Jake Olsen. Jake's little spin move inside. It's off the back of the rim. No good. Coming out of there with it. Going to be Cook for the Saints. And now with the chance to tie or go ahead. Saints are in the front court. Cook looks to try to throw the ball inside. He does. He gets it in there, but they kick it right back into Moore. He goes inside and double dribbles with it. He stopped to shoot it and then found out that he had Jake Olsen staring him right down the... And he couldn't get it over Jake, so they couldn't get over Jake. Now they got another guy out there. That's Sam Norm coming on the floor. He's wearing number 40. He's a 7-footer. He's out of Helena, Montana. Just a junior. And now in the front court, it's Milner. Looking inside, trying to find somebody. Anybody. He's going to have to go to Harris Williams. Harris Williams, he's in the paint with a little floater with his left hand. It's no good. He follows it up. That shot's no good. Coming out of there with a rebound is going to be the Saints. And they get the ball to Moore, and Moore's going to bring it in the front court. Still down two. They had a good look. Couldn't get it that time. Deep in the corner, that's Lang. Lang looking inside, trying to get it into Cook. No, that's going to be into the big man's hands. And he's going to, well, he's on the floor. He's fouled. Murek. Guzalochik. Guzalochik. Turkish name, hard to say. He was fouled in the first foul of the ball game. They're going to call that on Norm. He gets a lot of fouls. He doesn't spend a lot of time on the floor. Somehow or another, they know that he's a fouler. They go right at him. A nice job by Pedro as he tries to get around. Can't get it. Saved by Reed. Reed gets the ball to Davian Harris Williams. And now in the front court to Reed. He's in a big hurry. He takes it inside. Bodies on the floor. And no foul called. Coming out of the way, there's going to be Kendall Moore. 10:43 to play first half. Kendall's going to push a three-pointer on the way. It's up. It's good. And the Saints have their first lead of the ballgame, 18-17. And now Harris Williams. Front court. Moore's on him. He's going to take it inside the paint. Going to take his little step back. He's got Isaiah Moore on him now. His shot's up. Count that basket. And Harris Williams is going to go to the free throw line. How does he get those shots off? I'll never know. You know, they list him on the program as a six-footer, but I don't think he's that. I'm going to guess 5'10", maybe 5'11". Whatever the size is, he's a scoring machine. And Coach Isaacson, he's a little upset with the lack of a call down there the first time. They were last time they were down the floor. And this one is up, and he makes that one. Finishing off a three-point play, and we're all knotted at 19s. And with the ball on the far side, Isaiah Moore gives it off to Kendall. Kendall's going to dribble in the front court. He's got Milner in front of him. They're going to try to pick him off. Now Norm's got him. And now they're going to get Norm inside. Lang, nice take of the hole. Up and in. Beautiful take by James Lang. And now it's a two-point Saint lead. And there's Harris Williams. Takes it over the corner. That's Milner. Milner takes one dribble. Goes right to Reed. Reed, he's going to take it in the paint. And he's got a shot up. It's left. It's good. Nice take to the hole that time by Reed. Tying. And now the Argos are up two. Moore, he's in the front court now. Milner on him. Right up there at the center circle. They're going to run Isaiah past him. He goes left-hand side. And that's Pedra. And they're going to go to baseline with him and get a little give and go. And now have far side. That's going to be Isaiah. Moore, and then we have a holding foul. Now they're going to call it on Harris Williams. That's a bad foul for the Saints. That's two on Harris Williams. They cannot afford to have him on the bench, and that's right where he's got to go. And coming on the floor in his stead is going to be Caleb Carrington. He's a six-foot senior, and he's out of C.M. Russell High School. And now they get the ball inbounds. Out there on the floor is going to be Shahid Muhammad. And we're going to have another pushing foul going against the Argos. And that's going to be our fifth foul to two being called on the Saints. And that's going to be another one on Norm. He gets fouls in a hurry. He goes to the bench. Jake Olson comes back on. And now they're looking for something on the baseline to get the ball. Oh, my goodness. They're going to call a foul on Jake Olson. Inbounds past Isaiah Moore. He dropped the ball on the out-of-bounds line, and they're going to say that Jake fouled him somehow. And that's going to be Jake's. Is that his second foul? They're not listing it up there. They still got the previous foul up there. They're slow on the bench over there. And now they're going to bring the ball around the paint and get the ball. And that's going to be hand of Muhammad. He goes inside. And now there's another foul. And it's going to be another pushing foul. And they're going to call that one. They say on number zero. We don't have a number zero out there. Oh, yeah, we do. That's Carrington's number. They're going to call it on him. First free throw is up and good. Saints are within one now. Muhammad at the free throw line. Shahid, he's a 5'11 guard. He's out of Arden Hills, Minnesota. Second free throw is on the way, and that one's good as well. Now we're all knotted at 22s. And Reed's got the ball. Reed and Burton will be in the backcourt. We got Olsen out there, Carrington, and on the far side of the floor is going to be Milner. Milner's got the ball at the head of the key. Turns, looks, Reed, he's going to put up a three-pointer. It's out in the wing, it's good. Reed, he's feeling it now. Jalen Reed, that's his second three-pointer of the ball game. Three-point lead for the Argos. And now Cook, he's going to bring in the front court. Burton's going to pester him from the half-court line in. He works on the right-hand side. No, still on the dribble. He's trying to get by the defense. He does. We're going to get a foul on Burton, however, sending Andrew Cook to the free throw line. He's lightning quick. Cook is hard to guard. 8:47 to play as he goes to that free throw line. Seven fouls now on the Argos. Just two been called so far on the Saints. Andrew Cook at the free throw line. 6'4 junior out of Huntington Beach, California. First free throw is up and good. And now it's a two-point game. That stroke's on the way. It's a beautiful shot he's got. And now it's a one-point Argo lead. Reed with the ball. He'll bring it to the front court. Burton's going to be in the back court with him. And he's working over on the right-hand side. And he's working against Muhammad. Muhammad. Now it's going to be Burton, far side. It's going to be Reed. He's going to take it the paint. Kicks it in to Olsen. Olsen, he's got it. He's underneath the basket. Shots up. Olsen's got two. Nice job by Jake Olsen inside getting his basket there. And now it's a three-point Argo lead. 8:22 to play first half. Bringing the ball in the front court is going to be Muhammad. Muhammad being guarded by Carrington at the head of the key. He drops the ball off to Cook. Cook spins, looks. He's going to put a shot from the free throw line. It's good. I don't know if he can stop that. Still a one-point lead by the Argos. And now Reed's in the front court. He's going to be guarded out there by Muhammad. Head of the key, looking for somewhere to go. He wants to go left-hand side. Picks up his dribble. There's Milner. He's at the head of the key. Carrington's over here on the right-hand side, if that's where he wants to go. Olsen to set a pick on him. Olsen sets that pick, and Milner's got a shot. It's off the glass. It's no good. Rebound comes off. Coming out of there with a rebound is going to be Kramer for the Saints. Into the front court now. Muhammad, he's working on the left-hand side. Olsen cuts him off there. Now Isaiah Thomas. Or Isaiah Thomas. How about Isaiah? My bad. Isaiah Moore. He is a, puts his shot up no good, and now we come down this end of the floor. Jake Olsen hard of the hole. He's fouled. He's going to go shoot a couple free throws. They'd like to have Isaiah Thomas out there. Who wouldn't?
At the line, number 33,
Jake Olsen. Jake Olsen's at the free throw line. The 6'5 senior out of CMR. They're up one. He spends a lot of time at the free throw line. He gets a lot of practice there, so you expect him to be fairly good. And he is. He makes the first one. And they're going to bring Davian Harris-Williams back onto the floor with his two fouls. 7:31 to play. He's going to have to be careful. Don't want to pick up that third one. Jake's second free throw up and good. So we got Carrington guarding the ball. And it's going to be Muhammad bringing it in the front court. He's over here on the left-hand side looking for a play inside. What are they going to do? You're going to go left-hand dribble, right-hand dribble, head of the key. That's Kramer. Kramer, right-hand side. That's Moore. That's Isaiah. Isaiah has to back out towards the center circle. Oh, another player they got out there. That's going to be Josiah Carissimo. He's out of Missoula. And now they go over right-hand side. As the clock runs down, they got it into Cook. Long pass over here to the side of Carissimo. He misses the shot. And I think we're going to have Cook on the back on the rebound. I've been really terrible with my guesses so far today, but that one I think was pretty obvious. And it is on Cook, and we have a timeout on the floor. There's 7 minutes to play in the first half. Argos have 29. Saints have 26. Why don't we go ahead and take a break? We'll take a break for a full minute as the players sit
passion
back to KQDI.
It's what drives us. When you get your hands on something that you're passionate about, there's nothing else like it. That's the value of hands-on learning. So whether your passion is painting or plumbing, engines or engineering, if you're ready to turn your passion into a profession, find us at MSU Northern.
It's been a good day of basketball. The men have got the floor here for the Frontier Conference. Montana Tech kept their season alive with a one-point win over the Bulldogs out of Western in the game previous to this one. It was a nail-biter. Came right down to the end. The Bulldogs had the ball, put up the shot, and it went off the back of the rim. And Tech moves on. Bulldogs go home for the year. They're not going to make any playoffs, but Tech's going to make the playoffs whether they win or lose. This game, both of these teams, I'm probably going to need to win in order to move on. Carroll, though, they may be fortunate enough. They got the ball in the hands of Harris Williams. He takes it right in the paint. He puts up that patent shot of his. That's two more points for the Argos. And now Kendall Moore's back out there. And Reed's going to pick him up at the head of the key, gives him off to Olsen, goes in the corner. That's going to be Lang back out to Moore, far side. Muhammad, he's going to take it inside. That's Lang. Lang looking for nothing. And they get the ball in the big guy from Turkey. He's going to go baseline. And they're going to have a foul, and it's going to go against the Saints. And I think they're going to call it on Murat. Murat Gizalochik. No matter how many times I say it, it's going to be a hard name. Front court now. Harris Williams. Going to get a pick set by Vining. He's out there now. Vining. Watching as we all are as Harris Williams. So it's a shot up and that one missed. There's something you don't see very often. Front court now, Moore. Moore down 5 points as he brings the ball ahead of the key. Right-hand side, he's got Reed guarding him. Man-to-man defense still being played down there by the Argos. And that's Muhammad who goes across the paint, gets the ball to Lang. Lang stops, gives the ball. That's going to be Isaiah Moore. And they're going to call a foul. And it's going to go against Sam Vining. I guess there's a sigh of relief goes out because Harris Williams is standing in the same area. And that's going to send the Saints to the free throw line. And it's going to be James Lang at the free throw line. He's a 6-foot sophomore out of Portland, Oregon. Nice high arc and free throw. It's up and good. Cuts that lead to 4 points. 5:55 to play, first half. And now they're going to bring Guzalokchik in down along the paint there. Lang second shot's on the way. And that's good as well. And now it's one possession. 3-point lead by the Argos. Olsen gets it inbounds to Harris Williams. Harris Williams is bringing it in the front court. He's got Kendall Moore waiting for him. Right there at the center circle now. Left-hand dribble, looking for cutters. He goes over to Vining. Vining left side, drops it down into Reed. And he's being shoved down in there by Muhammad. And Shaheed's going to pick up his foul. That's going to be his second. Isaiah Moore goes to the bench. Cook comes back on the floor after a short break. And they say, while we're at it, why don't we go ahead and put G. Pedro out there as well. And now it looks like they've got their starting lineup out there. No, they got the big kid from Turkey in there as well. And now they're looking for somebody inside. They go over the top to Vining. They get out of him quick. They know he'll shoot that three and make it. And speaking of that, that's going to be Davian Harris-Williams. It's the ball at the Reed. He's going to launch one from the – oh, my goodness. I could have reached out and touched him. I mean, that's how far out here he was. He was on the county seal right there on the floor. You know, I hate to do the math, but that's, you know, I'm going to guess it's like 27 feet. It's good. 3 points for Reed and the Argos. And now they're up 34-28. Cook's got the ball. Gets inside to Gazalucic. He goes out on the far side. They're going to have a three-pointer up by Cook. It's almost automatic. He's a shooter, Andrew is. And now he gets him within three. 5:08 to play. Front court, Harris Williams on the dribble. He's got Moore guarding him. Goes down to Olsen. Olsen takes it inside. Got a shot up underneath the basket. And there's 2 points for Jake Olsen. Nice give and go that time. Set the pick, and Harris Williams threw a dime on that entry pass. And here comes G. Pedro. Gets the ball over to Lang. Lang looking to go, and he goes back to Pedro down in the corner. He's got defense on him. That's Burton as he gets the ball down to the big Guzalicic. And he forgot that dribble thing. I'm not sure what he's trying to explain to the referee. That's overseas. We don't have to dribble. I don't know what he's saying. Whatever it is. It's going against him, and he's upset. And so upset that he got a technical foul. If you're going to cuss at the refs, cuss in Turkish, I say. They may not know what you're saying. And at the free throw line, that's going to be Davian Harris-Williams that makes the first one. And he's got a second one coming, and that one's good as well. 37-31 now. Argos by six. And who are they going to give the ball to? I think it still stays with the Saints. And it does. They're going to get the ball on the baseline. Kendall Moore will take it out there in the box around the key. He's got Andrew Cook right in front of him. And they're going to try to set a pick, get it out to Lang. Yeah, they wanted to go Cook inside, but that didn't work. Said they had to Kramer. Kramer, he'll get it to Lang. He's got a shot up. Let's count that shot. And Harris Williams just got his third foul. And so the next 4:38, Argo's leading scorer is going to have to go to the bench and sit there for a while. Milner comes on. Harris Williams to the bench. Big, big loss for the Argos. And Lang's to the free throw line. Haven't made that shot. He's caught him within five. And the sophomore's got one more. He's going to get a free throw yet coming. He's 2 for 2 from the line. Taking his time, and he's got a nice harker. That one's good as well. And now it's a 4-point game. And Reed is there. He's going to take the point over now. He's got Reed and Burton bringing up the guard spot. Milner, he's going to play the post. He's way undersized for that. But they give the ball out to Burton. Burton looks right-hand side, looks at Reed, goes over to Vining. Vining, he can shoot the three, so they're out on him. And now Burton. Burton taking the ball in the hole. They're going to cut him off. He goes to the corner to Milner. Milner's going to dribble it out of there. There's Olsen. Back to Milner. Milner looks at the shot. Doesn't take it. Instead, he goes underneath the basket to Olsen. Olsen's got a layup. Beautiful pass by Milner. Nice entry pass. Nice catch by Olsen to catch it and get that layup. And now it's a six-point lead. And with the ball, is going to be Moore. Moore's on the dribble. Gets the ball over to Pedra. Pedra looks to something inside. He's got Kramer at the head of the key. And now Moore on the far side. Burton in front of him. There's Lang. That's running him across. He's going to stop, put up a shot there. Shot the rim, no good. He follows it. Gets the ball to Kramer. Kramer's got a layup. Nice job by Lang. Followed a shot, got the rebound, got it to the big guy inside, and they kept the lead to four. And here in the front court comes Milner. Milner to Olsen. Olsen to the head of the key. He's guarded there by Kramer. And now Burton. Burton, a little give and go. They go to the corner to Vining. Kicks it out of there, head of the key. Reed, he's farther out this time. That one's off the front of the rim. No good. Coming out of there with it, it's going to be Cook. Cook's over there on the right hand. He's on the dribble. They're going to be the defense back. He goes to Moore. Moore goes blown right by the defense. Goes inside. Ball gets knocked out of bounds. It's going to go back over to the Argos. Half the crowd didn't like that call. The referees looked at each other. Moore saying the ball was tipped. Ref said, I didn't see that. We're going to give the ball to the Argos. They're up four. 3:15 to play first half. And it's going to be Reed. Bringing to the front court. Jalen still on the dribble. They're going to try to double him up there. Has to pick up his dribble. There's Vining, and Vining's ball stolen by Cook. Cook can go down. He's got a dunk. And they're coming out of there up two now. And it's going to be Reed. He's at the head of the key. Need to take care of that basketball. The Saints are coming after it. Working over here on the right-hand side. Milner, no. And now Cook's all over him. He gets the ball into Olsen. Olsen turns, looks. Kramer on him. There's Vining underneath the basket. He's got the size on Lang. He puts his shot up, and it's good. Nice job by Vining. He hits two more points. We're going to have a timeout. 2:35 to play here in the first half. Argos 42, Saints 38, and there's a timeout on the floor. And I think it's going to be a 30-second timeout. So we're gone for 30 seconds. KQDI, 1450 AM.
Passion. It's what drives us. When you get your hands on something that you're passionate about, there's nothing else like it. That's the value of hands-on learning. So whether your passion is painting or plumbing, engines or engineering, if you're ready to turn your passion into a profession, find us at MSU Northern.
The basketball's been outstanding. The games have been closed. The crowds are happy. Sitting on the edge of the seat, what's going to happen next? So much talent out of there on the floor. Tech won the first game by one over Western, and now it's a four-point game with the Argos with the lead. Saints with the ball. We've got 2:28 to play here in the first half. Andrew Cook with the ball at the head of the key over to Kramer. Now to Moore. Moore being guarded by Burton has to go over to Pedro. That's G. Pedro. He's out of Brazil. He gets deep in the corner. That's going to be Cook. He's going to go baseline. Gets by Reed. Shots up. It's no good. Rebound comes off. Olsen's got it. He gets the ball in the hands of Reed, and Reed will bring it into the front court for the Argos. As the clock's going to roll under 2 minutes to play during this possession. He's looking on the right-hand side. That's going to be Burton. Burton looks down the corner. Milner's down there. Said he goes back over to Olsen. Olsen's out of the head of the key, left-hand side. Now to Milner at the head of the key. On the dribble. Looks on this side. There's Burton. Burton tried to take in the paint. Good defense. Has a stop, put up a 10-footer, but it's good. Nice shot by Burton. As he gets another basket in the ballgame, Javon putting in some good minutes or not losing ground while Harris Williams is on the bench. So good for the Argos that way, but they get the ball down late to Cook. Cook takes it inside, shots up. What are they going to call? Looked like a good check from where I sit, but not from where the ref was. They're going to call a foul. It's going to go into the Argos, and it's going to go into Jalen Reed. That's going to be his first. Argos bringing to the side of the relief because it wasn't on him. It was going to be on Olsen, and Olsen doesn't need any fouls. At the free throw line, Andrew Cook. Free throw's on the way, and it's good. Substitute coming on back on the bench as Isaiah Moore comes on, and Lang is going to go take a rest. For Coach Lundgren. And one more free throw for Andrew Cook. They're down five. And that one's no good. Rebound comes off. Olsen's got it. Gets to Milner. And the Argos are going to go back on the attack. They're up five with a minute 27 to play. He's in the front court. Kendall Moore comes out and get him. Number 10 guarding number 10. Now it's Burton. He's at the head of the key. Drops the ball off to Olsen. Olsen looks. Gets the ball to Reed. Reed almost loses it. He's got Andrew Cook on him. Gets the ball underneath the basket. That's Olsen. He's up and in. Jake doing yeoman work down there in that baseline. And now it's a 7-point lead. There's a minute and eight to play. Kendall Moore's in the front court. Burton's on him. And they work it over to Cook. Cook, he's got his back to the basket. Now a turn and look into the Moore. Kendall up and under. Beautiful shot. What a shot by Kendall Moore. Just sailed underneath that basket. Up and under from the, got the defense off him because he put the rim between them. And now there's 48 seconds. We got 20 seconds between that and the shot clock. As they're in the front court to Milner. Milner right side to Vining. Vining being guarded by Pedro. Goes ahead of the key. Now Cook's on him. Vining behind the back dribble. Going to do his little fadeaway. It's a little patented move he's got. And, of course, it's worth 2 points. Sam Vining. He's always been able to shoot, and he still does in his senior year here at University of Providence Argos. He doesn't want this to be his last game. He's one of the seniors out there on the floor. And now there's like a 0.3-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. So Kendall Moore is going to go stand in the corner. Defense is not in. There's no count. They're going to let that clock run down. Once he gets under 10 seconds, he's going to go to work. They're going to try to set the pick and get rid of him. Olsen playing the good defense. But he does get around him. Has to kick the ball back out. And with Isaiah Moore, he's going to travel with it. He's going to travel with it. And with 2 seconds, the ball is going to go back over to the Argos. Nice defensive stand that time by the Argos. As they're going to get the ball over in front of their own bench with 2 seconds, they're going to have to go the length of the floor. They're going to put Harris Williams out there. He must be the best launcher that they have because that's what they're going to get. Is it going to be a long shot throwing the ball in? They get Harris Williams. He's going to go to the left-hand sideline and shoot from the half-court line. He hit the backboard. I'll give him that. It isn't worth any points, but it's still going to go on the half of the lead. Up there on the back scoreboard, the Argos have 48. The Saints have 41. Let's go ahead and take a break for a couple minutes. I'll do some math, figure out who our scores were. Then we'll come back with a wrap-up of the first half and talk a little bit more about what's to come. Glenn Lambert with the call. This is KQDI, 1450 AM.
Montana has one of the highest suicide rates in the United States.
Suicide impacts people of all ages, genders, and ethnicities.
On average, 300 Montanans die each year by suicide.
Our best chance of stopping suicide is to stop the stigma.
It's time to talk openly and honestly about mental health issues.
Together, let's take the pledge to be allies against suicide.
Let's talk about it.
Let's talk about it.
Let's talk about it.
Ready to unleash your awesome? Then you need 8 gig all fiber internet from TDS. You'll have the powerful internet you need to stream, game, learn, and work today, and be prepared to take on anything new you can dream up tomorrow. Imagine internet you'll never outgrow. Get 8 gig all fiber internet from TDS and embrace infinite possibility.
Thank you.
At the University of Providence, we believe college is more than a collection of buildings, or a lecture, or a test, or even a degree. College is about connecting to something greater than yourself. The University of Providence is a private Roman Catholic liberal arts university founded in 1932 by the Sisters of Providence. And we continue to honor their vision by providing students with an education that goes beyond the classroom, an education grounded in our mission of connecting people. Connecting people with their communities, with one another, with the environment, with opportunities, with their spiritual journey, and most importantly, connecting people with their potential. The University of Providence.
For more than 85 years, D.A. Davidson has strived to build relationships and trust. From our first office in Montana to each of our 70 locations spread out coast to coast, we're on the ground and in your neighborhood, combining the values of a local partner with the capabilities of a national institution. We achieve strong outcomes based on mutual success, planning for future generations, and building legacies that endure together.
Passion. It's what drives us. When you get your hands on something that you're passionate about, there's nothing else like it. That's the value of hands-on learning. So whether your passion is painting or plumbing, engines or engineering, if you're ready to turn your passion into a profession, find us at MSU Northern.
Montana has one of the highest suicide rates in the United States.
Suicide impacts people of all ages, genders, and ethnicities.
On average, 300 Montanans die each year by suicide.
Our best chance of stopping suicide is to stop the stigma.
It's time to talk openly and honestly about mental health issues.
Together, let's take the pledge to be allies against suicide.
Let's talk about it.
Let's talk about it.
Let's talk about it.
Montana. We're proud to say it's where we live and where we work. We're so much more than pretty scenery. We are all hardworking, resilient, and resourceful. The vibe is different here. Stockman Bank, Montana's brand of banking.
The other guys. They think they know what special means. At Godfather's Pizza, we do special, and we do it better. We add the T. There's a Godfather's specialty pizza with your name on it. Classic combo, all meat combo, hot stuff, taco, yeah, even veggie, and more. All of them piled high with the best toppings and 100% real cheese. Treat yourself special. Order specialty pizzas from Godfather's Pizza.
My name is Matt Allen. I'm the Director of Admissions at the University of Montana Western. Montana Western is the only U.S. public institution in the country that operates on a block scheduling model called Experience One. Instead of your semester looking like this in a traditional system, the block schedule at Montana Western looks like this. This innovative approach allows students to really focus on that one homework area, have one final, communicate with one professor. More importantly, there's one professor communicating with that class. The big difference between Montana Western and other institutions is that our students typically have 2 to 3 years of experience in their field of study. And it's experience that employers and grad schools are looking for. And like I said, it's experience that a lot of college students don't typically have at that point in time in their academic career. Student success is our top priority, so our faculty and staff are here to help students through their entire student experience.
If you are on the fence about ordering McDonald's, consider this a sign.
And that sign is to get a satisfying breakfast sandwich for just $2 when you order ahead on the app. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Still?
Yeah.
How many pages got left?
30.
Break time.
Good looking out.
I got you.
Buy one, get one for a dollar is back. So double up or mix and match. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Here we go. All we need is an open road and a chance to see a never-ending world that's beautiful. Here we go. With the sunlight on our skin, it's a brand new day. It's ours to take and we will let it in. This is where the adventure begins.
The Heritage Inn is just off I-15 in Great Falls and minutes from the C.M. Russell Museum, the Lewis and Clark Interpretive Center, Giant Springs State Park, and many other attractions. You'll be near Malmstrom Air Force Base, Great Falls International Airport, and the River's Edge Trail along the Missouri River. After a day of travel, sightseeing, or fly fishing, unwind in the hot tub and take a dip in our heated pool. There's an exercise facility and a steam room. We have a full range of dining and entertainment options, including the Max Casino and Sports Bar, the Palomino Coffee Bar, and the Willow Creek Restaurant. Your accommodations will include satellite TV, in-room movies, a refrigerator, a microwave, a coffee and tea maker, and high-speed Wi-Fi. For an unforgettable trip to Great Falls, make your reservation at the Heritage Inn.
Scrap metal for cash? Come visit us at Central Montana's leader in recycling, Steel Etc. in Great Falls. Our center processes steel, stainless steel, aluminum, copper, brass, and lead. And we pay cash for scrap based on weight. We also accept batteries, electric motors, paper, cardboard, and more. And our roll-off containers are available for any scrap projects you have. We even buy and recycle junk cars. Trade your scrap for cash. Visit us at steeletc.com or call us at 761-4848.
This season, score big with one of our many cars under $30,000. Talk about winning plays. Our financing team is here to help you with affordable options. We offer payments under $500, and that means more money for your fantasy football bets. With our certified pre-owned lineup, every car is thoroughly inspected so you can drive with confidence. That means getting to the game without worry.
Just over the hill.
On hand, I know Carroll, they follow their team real well, and they have a nice crowd here. Of course, you get the games back-to-back. As soon as this one's done, they wait to take the field. It's going to be the Carroll ladies team, They're the number one team in the conference, and they'll be playing Rocky Mountain College, and that should be a good ball game. Rocky Mountain College, you've got Leckfold from Scobie. She was just nailing those three-pointers yesterday, and they've got some other outside shooters, Kai Oliver. They will challenge Carroll. It's just not a given that Carroll's going to waltz through this tournament as the number one team. They are the defending champions, and they're coming back to defend that. And they do have some really good ball players, but so do these other squads. And on a given day, you never know. Rocky looked real good yesterday in their win. And now they're going to get a chance to knock off the conference champions. And when that game's over, it's going to be your Argos right here at University of Providence. They're going to come out there and take the floor and try to get into the championship game. It sounds like they're going to have a play-in game. So the Argo gals, either win or lose, if they win, they're going to go automatically to the national championship. But if they lose, there's going to be a play-in game. It's going to be over at the McLaughlin 7 on the 15th and 16th of March. They're going to bring in three other teams from around the country. They're all kind of like bubble teams, and they'll have a couple of semifinals. They'll meet for the champion, and that winner is going to get to go to the national championship game. All at the McLaughlin Center, 15th and 16th of March. That's going to be more good basketball. So come on out and watch. This is a lot of talent coming into Great Falls, and they bring the crowds, they bring the money. It's good for the economy, and it's fun basketball to watch. We're getting ready for the second half now, and the Argos have the lead, and they get the ball to start the second half. As soon as everybody's shoes are tied. Okay, Kendall's ready. Now we go. Damian Harris-Williams back out there. And he gets the ball over to Reed. Reed out to the key. That's Olsen. Olsen over to Harris-Williams. He's on the dribble. A little give and go to Olsen. Lang broke it up. Knocked the ball out of bounds. It's going to be Argo ball baseline. Nice defense that time by James Lang. And taking it out on the baseline. That's going to be Harris-Williams. He's got Olsen right in front of him. He's got Sam Vining behind Olsen. And the over the top, looking for something, and they're going to go in the corner to Sam Vining. He shoots that three from the corner about as well as anybody. That one does not drop. Coming out of there, though, getting the rebound is going to be the Saints. And they get the ball to Andrew Cook, and he's going to bring it in the front court. Defense picking up right there. That's Burton. He goes over to Pedro. Pedro, now Kramer. He's at the head of the key, hands it off to Moore. Moore tries to get by Olsen. That's not going to happen. Now Burton cuts him off. Over here on the right-hand side, Moore again. Kramer says, I want the ball inside. I got Olsen behind him. Can't get it in there. He goes over to Cook on the far side. He gets Reed on the fake, goes inside. That shot's going to be short. Ball gets knocked down. They say it's off of the Saints. And it's going to come into the Argos up 48-41. They haven't scored. Nobody scored here in the second half. Harris Williams is going to bring the front court. He's got Moore going to guard him. Now he's going to come across the top of the key. Now he's got Pedro. He goes in the corner. Now Reed's going to put up a three. That's off the front of the rim. No good. Rebound comes off. Pedro's got it for the Saints. He's going to dribble it out of trouble, get the ball to Moore, and Moore will bring it in the front court. Moore, he's working over here on the right-hand side to Lang. Lang on the far side to Pedro. Pedro looks for something inside. He goes over to Kramer. He's at the head of the key. That's not his shooting area. Nobody's out on him at all. And now Moore. Moore with Burton on him. He'll shoot it, so they're not going to have him free. Lang, he's a shooter, too. He's got Vining on him. Goes by Vining. Shot's no good. Cook's on the backside. He's got the rebound. He's going to dribble it out of there. Ball hit the rim, so they get no, they don't get a fresh clock. Must not hit the rim. I thought it did. Meanwhile, Pedro, he's got a three-pointer on the way. It's off the back of the rim, no good. Olsen's got the rebound, gets the ball to Burton, gets the ball to Reed, gets the ball to Harris-Williams, and they're going to bring it into the front court. Harris-Williams with Moore on him. He's working over on the right-hand side, and now he's going to come left across the top of the key, still on the dribble, and now he's got Pedro in front of him. Pedro goes right by him, little shot, little give and go in the paint, shot's up and good. He held the ball away from his body at arm's length, and then in the last second, flips it up with a wrist shot. It goes in. He is fun to watch. This Harris Williams is a shooter. And now Moore on this end. Now they're down nine. I think that might be the biggest lead of the ball for the Saints. And then he got the ball to Pedro. He's on the dribble out front. He's got left-hand side. Moore, he goes by Burton, gets the ball inside. They have to kick it back out. They got it into Kramer, but they were crowding around him. Nothing he could do with it. The ball gets knocked out of bounds by the Argos. It's going to be Saints ball, baseline, Moore to take it out. Kendall, he's got Cook right in front of him. And they're going to try to send it Lee Lang here in the corner. So they go into Kramer. Kramer's going to go against Olsen, try to back his way in there. Olsen playing the good defense. Nothing he can do. He can throw it over the top. Gives it to Vining. Vining gets the ball down. And they got Reed. He's got a layup on the far end. Shots up. Shot. He went sailed underneath the basket. And in the air, he backspins it off the glass. And that thing went in. That was a pretty shot. And now it's 52-41. It's an 11-point lead by the Argos. And Coach Lundgren, he wants to talk about some things. He's going to take a full minute to do with 7:24 to play here in the second half. Argos 52, Saints 41. We're back in a minute. KQDI 1450.
We invite you to stay at one of the newest hotels in Great Falls. Warm, friendly atmosphere, and a friendly staff that's ready to assist you in your every need. When you check in, this is the kind of room you will receive. Clean and comfortable, where you get wonderful breakfast and how about a nice glass of wine upon your check-in. Easy check-in with your professional team to assist you. Make your next reservation at the Gibson, downtown Great Falls.
Chose this game here at the Four Seasons Arena because there's a nice crowd on hand. Carroll always brings a nice crowd. They follow their team so well. Home and away, they get nice crowds up there. So I was talking to Doug Hashey, the AD for the Argos. I said he kind of took a hit yesterday when both the Carroll teams got byes in the first day because nobody from Helena came to watch. He said, well, that's true, but we still had a nice crowd. They're happy with the crowds that are here. Andrew Cook's going to take it out right here in front of me. Now Carroll gets the ball, and they are down 11. And he gets the ball into Cook. Cook's got Burton right on top of him. Going to back off there, get the ball to Pedro, ahead of the key, over to Cook. Excuse me, Moore being guarded by Rune, tries to get inside. Defense cuts him off. Now Lang, he looks at that three-pointer, takes the ball inside. He's got Cook. He's got a little floater. It's up. It's no good. Rebound comes off. Vining's got it. Gets the ball to Harris Burton. Harris Williams, and Javon's going to bring it to the front court. Moore picks him right up there at the half-court line, tries to go backdoor on him. That doesn't work. Still on the dribble. Has to pick it up now, and that's going to be Reed. Reed is going to take it all the way to the baseline. His shot's up underneath the basket. It's no good. He hits the floor. There's no call. Cook gets the rebound. He's in a hurry to this end of the floor, and he goes against David Williams. Williams gets it. Harris Williams just gets out of the way. He's got three fouls. Nothing he could do with that. Now it's with Vining. Vining with Cook on him. Back over to Harris Williams, and he's got Cook right in his face, or Moore right there in his face. Turns, looks, goes to the right-hand side. Kramer tries to cut him off. Picks up his dribble, goes inside. Says, if Kramer's out here, Olsen's in there. Olsen goes for a shot. He gets checked. And coming out of there with it's going to be Pedra. Good thought by Harris Williams. Just didn't work. And now it's going to be Lang. Lang gets the ball to Moore. Moore takes inside with a beautiful little dish inside to Kramer. Bodies are on the floor. And they're going to call a foul on somebody. There's a lot of people to pick from in there. And they're going to give the second foul to number 23. And for 23, that is going to be a foul on Burton. That's just going to be his second. And it's the team first in the second half. First foul by either team in the second half. Worth the 16-13 mark. Moore will take it out on the baseline. And where's he looking for? He's all the way over the top to Lang. Lang, left-hand side now to Cook. Cook falls to the floor. And they're going to call a foul on Reed. I'm not so sure about that, but then my opinion counts nothing. 16-8 now, still a 9-point lead as they take it out. That's Isaiah Moore back out there. Throws it to Kendall Moore. Kendall's at the head of the key, drops it in into Guzalucic. He puts it up and under. Shot's no good. Ball gets knocked out of bounds. They're going to say it's off of Isaiah. Guzalucic, he's upset with himself. Missed a point-blank layup. To give him his due, there was defense all around him. And now Reed, up 9, brings in the front court as we roll under 16 minutes to play. There's Olsen. He's out at the head of the key on the dribble. Hands the ball to Harris Williams. Harris Williams on the dribble, head of the key, left-hand side. Moore's got him now, doing some fancy dribbling, but he's not getting anywhere. And now he's backs off to the center circle, going to go left-hand side, tries to get to Olsen. Good defense being played by Cook. He comes out of there with it, and they've got a 3-on-2. They're going to go in the corner. Lang's got a 3-pointer on the way. It's up. It's no good, but I think they're going to call a foul. Is it off ball? Yes, it is. And it's going to go against. Yeah, it's going to go against Guzalucic, I believe. And that is going to be his third foul. Ball goes over to the Argos. They're still up 9, 15-31 to play. wiping up all the sweat off the floor. Anytime those bodies hit the floor, there's water on them. And it's going to be Harris Williams in the front court. Moore guarding him right there. He wants to work on the right-hand side. Gives it off to Reed. Reed looks inside. Has to go to Olsen. Olsen, he's on the dribble to Harris Williams. Harris Williams looks taking the paint. He's got a shot in there. And his shot's no good. He's fouled. He's going to get go to the free throw line and shoot two free throws. Harris Williams, speed up, slow down. He's got all kinds of steps inside there. Hard to defend. 15-17 to play, second half. He's at the free throw line to shoot two, and they're going to call that foul, the second one, on Andrew Cook. And the senior goes to the free throw line to shoot two free throws. And the first one's no good. He doesn't miss many. He missed that one. As we have Kramer coming back on the floor, and Guzlochik takes his three fouls to the bench. One more free throw for Damian Harris-Williams. One of the few people, he doesn't dribble the ball before his free throws. He just gets the ball, looks at the rim, sets, and shoots it. And he does it with an astounding good accuracy. So anyway, here comes the second ball. Basket was good. Cook's in the front court. Now to Lang, now to Cook, as he takes it across the top to Kendall Moore. Kendall's on the dribble with Burton guarding him. And over here to Cook now. Cook's got Reed on him. He's going to hand him off to Vining. Vining, he gets by Vining on the baseline. Vining's got his hands on him. Sam, he's not quick enough, really, to be guarding Cook one-on-one. Sam's got a lot of things he brings to the floor, foot speed not being one of them. And now Moore to throw it out on the baseline. He's got Lang in the corner. He's going to put up a little 10-footer. It's good. They got to foul and find him. They've run that play before. Good thing they only ran it for a two-pointer instead of a three-pointer. Now it's 8-point lead by the Argos as Harris Williams brings it in the front court. And he's on the dribble on the left-hand side. And he gets the ball into Sam. Sam, little spin move inside. And he's going to do that little fadeaway that he's got. It's up, and it's off the front of the rim. No good. Cook gets the rebound. Gets it to Moore. Moore's going to bring it in the front court. Looking over here on the right-hand side to Lang. Lang's in a big hurry. Gets it into Kramer. No, good defense being played by Vining, but he swatted the ball out of there, but he swatted it over to Lang. And another basket. Now it's a 6-point lead. Good defense by Vining, but it just didn't work out. Batted the ball to the wrong guy, and now Reed, he's at the free throw line. Got defense on him. Cook knocks him to the floor. That's going to be the third foul on Cook. He's going to have to be careful now, too. Both the main players on these teams have three fouls. Harris Williams got three. Cook's got three. And it'll be Argo ball, baseline, or excuse me, over there in front of their bench. As Cook's going to take his three fouls on the bench and coming on in, his place is going to be Josiah Carissima. And they get the ball into Reed. Reed over to Olsen. Olsen's going to dribble it over to the right-hand side, give it to Damian Williams. Harris. Harris Williams on the dribble. Gets the ball on Moore. Moore's trying to get by him. Moore's playing a good defense. There's a fadeaway. It's no good. Rebound gets swatted back up there. That was going to be Burton. His shot's no good. Coming out of there now is going to be the Saints. Argos have gone cold here. They're letting the Saints right back in this ballgame with their poor shooting. And now Lang. Lang goes by Vining, but he has to go out to Moore. Moore gets a nice cut to the basket, throws it to Kramer. Kramer wasn't ready for it. And they're going to say that nobody touched it. Kramer's claiming that he didn't. He didn't have to. Nobody touched it. Moore threw it. And it's going to go over to the Argos. And everybody's walking over towards their benches. That means there's going to be a timeout there on the floor. 13:42 to play here in the second half. Argos have 53. The Saints have 47.
Scrap metal for cash? Come visit us at Central Montana's leader in recycling, steel, etc. in Great Falls. Our center processes steel, stainless steel, aluminum, copper, brass, and lead. And we pay cash for scrap based on weight. We also accept batteries, electric motors, paper, cardboard, and more. And our roll-off containers are available for any scrap projects you have. We even buy and recycle junk cars. Trade your scrap for cash. Visit us at steeletc.com or call us at 761-4848.
Basketball. We are on the second semifinal game. The Argos are leading the Saints 53-47. They'll have the basketball when they break out of this timeout and go down and see if they can get that, add to that lead. Set up the scenario here. Davian Harris-Williams, he's the leading scorer for the Argos. He's got three fouls. Andrew Cook, the leading scorer for the Saints, he's got three fouls. Still a lot of basketball to be played. Argos will take the ball on the baseline. It's going to be, Burton's going to throw it in down there. That's going to be Javon Burton. He gets the ball into Jalen Reed. Back to Burton, and he loses control of the ball. He went to pick it up, and he just locked it. Oh, but he got it back. Nice job by Burton. He's just going, wow, the heck did I just mishandle that ball? He handed it right to Carissima, but nothing he could do. He'd come down the floor and got his hand on the ball, got it back. Reed now, Olsen. Olsen gets the ball to Harris-Williams. A little give and go. There's Olsen. Underneath the basket, that's going to be Javon Burton. That's up, and that's in. He went underneath the basket, made it. And now we have a whistle after the play. Referee's saying something. I think they're telling the Saints to quit whacking the ball around after it goes through the basket. I'm not sure. Talking to Isaiah Moore, whatever it was, whatever it is, it's over. And now with an 8-point deficit here, come front court's Kendall Moore. Kendall, he's got Burton right on time. Going to go on the left-hand side. That's head of the key, Lang. Quickness in the key. Now Carissima, far side. Get the ball down there. That's going to be Lang again. He takes it inside. That shot short. No good coming out of there with it. There's going to be Harris-Williams. Quickly down the floor. There's Burton. He's got it down to that end. He's got up. He's got another lap, and it's good. They didn't waste any time getting down the floor that time. Now it's a 10-point lead. And here comes Moore back in the front court. Burton's going to pick him up at the head of the key. He goes right by him. He's inside. Reed, beautiful job. Getting the swat on that ball. And he's going to take it down all by himself on this end. He's got a lap. Count the basket. And he's going to get a point from the free throw line if he can shoot it. Jalen Reed gets a check on the one end. Gets that ball, takes it to the length of the floor, puts a shot up, makes the basket, goes to the free throw line. And now it's a 59-47 point lead. 12 points for the Argos. They're up. And we're going to have to get Cook back on the floor. He's out there. And they're going to bring Prater as well. Lang goes to the bench. Kramer goes to the bench. Reed goes to the free throw line. Try to finish off a three-point play. Somebody from the Argos got to fill that slot in there. No, they don't. They're all four standing out here. They have such confidence that Reed's going to make this free throw. They're not even taking lane spots. 12:34 to play. Argos by 12. Argos by 13. And now we're going to be quick to take the ball out. Before that, we're going to have a timeout. 12:34 to play here in the second half. Argos have 60. Saints have 47. And they're not going to take a timeout. Now everybody's going to sit back down. This just confused the announcer. That's what they're playing. And now Moore's got the ball. He's going to be guarded with a little full court pressure by Burton. Or that's Milner who's out there now. And he's in the front court working on Milner. Takes it inside. Runs into Olsen. Has to kick the ball out to, that's going to be Carissima. He's got a really nice move. And no, there's Reed with another big block. He come up out of nowhere and just swatted that ball out of there. Deep in the corner, that's Mining. He's got a three on the way, and it's good. And the Argos are putting on a show. This is how they can play ball. Now they're up 63-47 over the Saints. 12 minutes to play as the Saints go into the front court. And he's got Cook with the ball. He's over here to Isaiah Moore. Isaiah being guarded by Vining. Trying to work Vining inside. Stop, free throw line. That shot's up. That shot's good. Big shot by Isaiah Moore to break up that run by the Argos. But the Argos are back on the attack. Harris Williams with the ball as it brings in the front court. Carissima is going to guard him right there ahead of the key. They're going to set a free to go to Reed on the left-hand side. No, they're going to go inside to Vining. He's got that little, he can't control the ball. He still can't control it. Ball gets kicked around over there, finally coming out of there with it. It's going to be the Saints. That's going to be Moore. Moore's coming back. Harris Williams, he's got his three fouls. He's got to get out of the way. He does. Shots up. And there's going to be a foul called. And who are they going to call this one on? They're going to call it the third foul on Reed. And they got to wipe the sweat off the floor. And we're going to go to the free throw lines. Isaiah Moore is going to get to shoot two. They're down 63-49. He'd like to cut into that 14-point lead. And he does with the first one. No subs coming off the bench for the first time in a long time. As he's going to shoot one more. Isaiah. He's a 6'5 sophomore out of Fairfield, California. And that one's good. And now it's a 12-point lead by the Argos. Burn front court, Milner, Reed, left-hand side to Vining. Vining, a little lob pass into Olsen. He didn't lob it enough. Pater got the pickoff, and he's going to get the ball to Cook. Going to have to throw a better entry pass than that. They were waiting for it. And now Cook, he's at the head of the key, working over there on the left-hand side, deep in the corner. That's going to be Moore with a three, and it's good. Isaiah Moore, one single-handedly, bringing the Saints back in this ball game. And here comes Harris Williams. He's got a lane to the basket. He's fouled in the act of shooting. And that probably will go against Pedro. They can pick who they want. There were multiple people on him. It's going to send Harris Williams to the free throw line. And they're up. They're only up 9 points now. And before he goes to the free throw line, now they're going to call a timeout. So with 11:02 to play here in the second half, Argos 6-3, Saints 54. Let's go and take a break for a minute. We'll be back. KQDI, 1450 AM.
Passion. It's what drives us. When you get your hands on something that you're passionate about, there's nothing else like it. That's the value of hands-on learning. So whether your passion is painting or plumbing, engines or engineering, if you're ready to turn your passion into a profession, find us at MSU Northern.
And welcome back to the listening audience out there, all you basketball fans. You're missing out on some really, really good basketball here. Argos right now have just a 9-point lead. They're going to send Davian Harris-Williams to the free throw line. He's a good free throw shooter. Hopefully he can get that lead back into double figures. There's 11:02 to play here in the second half. Argos win or they are done for the year. Carroll, they can probably lose this game and maybe get into the Nationals. I'm not sure winner of this game is going to play Tech tomorrow. And Tech, a 1-point winner over Western earlier today, and the free throw's on the way, and it's good. That was quite a ball game, 83-82, I think the final score was. It was quite a match. Western had a shot right at the buzzer, 15-footer, hit the back of the rim, went out. That thing goes in. Tech season would not be over. They're going to the Nationals no matter what. But Western now, because they missed that, they're done. And the second free throw's up. It's good as well. Now it's an 11-point lead with 11 minutes to play. And in the front, quickly in the front court, that's going to be Moore. Tries to go by everybody. He gets Milner. Milner reaches out, fouls him. Well, shot goes in. That was Muhammad that was doing that. Shahid Muhammad. I didn't see him come on the floor after the timeout. He brings a lot of quickness out there, makes that basket, cuts the lead to 9. Milner goes to the bench. Reed's back out there now. And so is Carrington. Caleb Carrington, he's from CMR. Free throws on the way, and that was good. Completes a 3-point play. And now it's an 8-point lead by the Argos. The Saints are clawing their way back into this thing. They were down 14 at one time. And now Harris Williams, he's in the front court with Muhammad on him. Goes on the right-hand side to Vining. Vining looking for a dribble. No, he goes to Reed at the head of the key. Reed couldn't get the lob to Olsen. Olsen wanted it. Steady gets it on the baseline. And there's Vining in the corner. He's got a 3-point shot on the way. It's no good. And Harris Williams gets the rebound. Little spin move brings it out to Reed. He's going to launch a three of his own. That one's off the side of the rim. No good. Carrington's got it. He takes it inside, throws the ball out front, and now it's Vining. Vining to Reed, and now Harris Williams as they set up their offense with 14 seconds to go. Harris Williams, he's got Muhammad on him. He's going to get picked by Olsen, and he's at the head of the key now with Pedro on him. Tries to go down. Good defense being played by Muhammad. He steals a bounce pass, goes over here to Pedro. Pedro, left-hand side, now to Moore, Isaiah Moore to Ken, to Muhammad. Muhammad's got Olsen on him. He's got the quickness against the size. And they're going to call something against the Saints. I'm not sure what they're calling. Ball's going over to the Argos. I was looking through a whole sea of people. I couldn't see what happened on that far side of the floor. Referee did. And Coach for Carroll didn't put up much of a fuss, so it must have been a correct call. And now it's going to be Olsen. Olsen hands the ball off to Reed. Reed tries to split the seam to go inside. They're going to have a blocking foul. That's going to go against Muhammad. And that's going to be the sixth team foul on the Saints. There's also been five that have been called on the Argos. And from now on, all fouls by the Saints are going to send the Argos to the free throw line as Kendall Moore comes back on the floor and Cook goes to the bench. That'll be a short break, I'll bet you. They won't leave him over there for long. Carrington now with the ball. Tried to set a pick. And he's getting the paint. He gets the ball down. Tries to get to Olsen. Said to go out in the corner. That's going to be Reed. Baseline. And the ball is partially checked. That's Moore playing the good defense. And they're coming out of there with it's going to be Muhammad. Muhammad is down at this end of the floor. Pedro, there's Moore. He's going to, oh, he went to shoot the three. Carrington playing the good defense. Flew right at him. Moore took the ball right back down to the ground. Travel. Ball goes over to the Argos over there in front of the Carroll bench. Reed will take it out. Harris Williams to get the entry pass. And they're on the dribble as we get down to 9:30 to play here in the second half. On the dribble, it's going to be Harris Williams working on the left-hand side. He's got that spin move inside, and he loses control of the ball. It goes to Kendall Moore. Moore and Reed. Reed's got three fouls. He's got to be careful. Shots up. Shots good. Nice take to the hole that time by Carroll as they get the lead down to 6 points. Regardless, with a six-point lead, Argos are going to the free throw line. And Harris Williams is going to put that one in. And the senior's got one more coming. He does not want this to be his last game as an Argo. It's good as well. And now it's an eight-point lead for the Argos, and they get the ball. They're going to get right over there at the half-court line. And it'll be Carrington to throw it in. Harris Williams is who they're going to get it to, and they get it to Devon. And he's working on the right-hand side. Moore's on him. Makes a pick up his dribble. Goes Olsen ahead of the key. Olsen looking back door to Reed. That's not there. Goes to Carrington. Carrington, the give and go to Olsen. That's not there. He goes to Olsen to the sideline. Reed's calling for the ball underneath the basket. Vining's got the ball. He's at the free throw line, working his way in the paint there. He's got that little fadeaway jumper that he does. It's a low percentage shot for anybody else on the planet, but not for Sam Vining as he drains that one. And now it's a 10-point lead again. And now it's going to be Isaiah Moore. He's had a hot streak here just a second ago. Now it's going to be Kendall. He's going to take it all the way in. Good defense by Olsen, but he goes right over the top of him. Good for 2 points. How they get those shots up with those big guys, I'll never know. 8:28 to play, and it's going to be Reed. He's in the front court, guarded by Muhammad. They got themselves an eight-point lead. He gives the ball to Harris Williams. Harris Williams working on the right-hand side. Looks for the give-and-go to Olsen, and that's not there. Nobody's guarding Sam Vining in the corner. Oh, and he misses one. Sam doesn't miss very many of those. He doesn't have that touch from the corner today. He's missed two of them. That's probably about as many as he's missed all year. Moore, he's got a three-pointer on the way. That one's no good. Rebound. Harris Williams gets it. He goes up. Gets by into the front court. He's at the free-throw line. Gets tripped. And they're going to call a foul. And it's going to go against Lang. And it's going to be a shooting foul because everything's shooting now for the Argos. That's the eighth team foul on the Saints. So it's going to send Harris Williams to the free throw line to either shoot a one and one or two. I'm not sure. And here comes Edder Cook back on the floor. Charisma is not there with him as well. Pedro, Muhammad, and Kendall Moore are out there still for the Saints. I got Vining, Reed, Harris Williams, Carrington, and Burton out there for Coach Isaacson. Harris Williams at the free throw line. He's got shot on the way. He's that nice high arcer. It's good. And now he's got another one. Harris Williams got one more coming. 18 fouls on the Saints. 15 fouls on the Argos. 8:01 to play, second half. And the senior Harris Williams at the free throw line. Shooting the second of his free throws. And, of course, it's good. He's an excellent shooter, good at the free throw line. 10-point lead by the Argos. Quickly in the front court comes Muhammad. Harris Williams picks him right there at the head of the key. Now it's going to be Cook, guarded out there by Reed. And they get the ball over the sideline, hands it right back to Cook. Reed's on him. He's trying to back his way inside the paint. They're going to come over there, Kerrigan with a double team. Now Moore, he's going to go baseline. Inside, Reed with the defense. It's no good. Rebound gets swatted out of bounds. And they're going to give it to the Saints. Saints ball baseline, Moore to take it out. They're in a box around the paint with Cook right in front of him. And where they're going to go, they'd love to go over here in the corner to Muhammad. That's who's got it. And he's got Burton guarding him. Gets the ball to Cook. Cook with Reed on him. He's going to go baseline. Carrington cuts him off. Throws the ball to the top to Charisma. Charisma to the corner to Moore. Three-pointer right at the buzzer. Beautiful shot by Kendall Moore. Cuts that lead to 71-64. That was a big, big shot over there right as that buzzer's going off. He lays a long three-pointer. And now Reed, he's on the dribble. He goes inside. He's got his layup up in there, and it's good. Nice take to the hole by Jalen Reed. And now it's back to that nine-point lead. 7-11 to play, and somebody better get on Muhammad. He's in a big rush to get down the floor. Nobody gets in front of him. He's got a layup. Muhammad is lightning quick. 7 minutes to play now in the ball game, and it's a seven-point lead by the Argos. Reed, front court, Vining to set a pick for him. He's on to work on that right-hand side. back his way inside against Chrisma. He puts a shot up, it's no good, but he's fouled in active shooting. And Jalen's going to go to the free throw line. Half the gym wants to travel. The other half says, no, it's a good call. The call that is going to be happening, it was a timeout. With the 6:50 to play here in the second half, Argo's up 73-66 over the Saints. We're going to take a timeout. It's going to be a full timeout. We'll be gone for a minute. KQDI, 1450 AM.
Introducing the new and improved taste of Pepsi Zero Sugar. Now more delicious. Zero never tasted so good. Try it now.
So many flavors of dew. I am thirsty. I must get the dew.
Cut, cut. He's hypnotized again.
Do the dew.
Has so many good players, so many good teams. All these games have been just really exciting. First game of the semifinal was a one-point game won by the defending, two-time defending champion Tech as they beat their rivals Western by one. It came right down to the wire. Western missed a two-pointer right at the buzzer. Otherwise, Tech's season would have not been over, but they would have been out of their championship, and their dreams of back-to-back-to-back would have been over. And now we have Reed at the free-throw line, and he will be shooting, too, from... And his first shot's on the way, and it's good. He's a good free throw shooter as well. And Jalen's going to get his second free throw as he stretches that lead out to 8 points. One more free throw to go. Taking his time. These are big free throws. He's a senior as well. He doesn't want his season end either. And he makes that second free throw. And now Muhammad. Muhammad's going to bring it in. Now they are down 9 points as he gets in the front court. He's lightning quick. Who's going to be on him? Burton. Burton to get the ball over to Chrisma. Chrisma at the head of the key. Guarded by Harris Williams. Back over to Muhammad. He's at the head of the key now on the dribble. Working his way over the other side of the floor. And they're going to call a foul on Cook. And that's going to be his fourth. That was an illegal pick. And that's four on the big on their best player. And it was... He clipped the guys. He went by him. You know, at the college level, I don't know if I'd have called that. I'm not going to question referees. I did it for 44 seasons. It's a hard job. From where he sat, it looked like a foul from here. Yeah. Anyway, Harris Williams in the front court. Gets the ball over to Reed. Reed over the far side now. Burton. Burton's at the head of the key. Going to put out a couple moves, try to go inside. Cook shuts him off. Backdoor. Chrisma. He goes all the way through the baseline. Gets the ball inside to Olsen. Olsen, little spin shot up and in. Jake Olsen with another basket in the ball game. Jake, he's having a good game. He's got 12 points as... Cook's got the ball with his four fouls. He's going to bring in the front court. Reed's on him. And he's going to try to take the ball. Olsen cuts him off there. They're going to double team him out there at the center circle. Now it's going to be Moore. Kendall's on the dribble. Wants to take it inside. And he's going to get fouled by Reed. Nope. They're going to call that one on Olsen, I think. Well, better Olsen. That's his second. Would have been, I think it would have been four had they called that ball on Jalen. Moore's going to go to the free throw line to shoot a couple. They're down 11. Kendall Moore. He's a 5'11 guard out of Dayton, Ohio. Free throw's up and good. Cuts the lead to 10. And he takes his time. Just a junior. We're going to have to put up. No, is it? Second free throw's off the front of the rim. No good. Burton's got the rebound. And now they're going to bring in the front court. That's going to be Davian Harris-Williams, guarded by Moore. And he spins it off to Isaiah Moore, who's out there now. And still Davian on the dribble, burning up a little bit of clock. Now Cook's on him. He goes right by Cook. There's that extended layup again. He puts that ball way outside of his body. And he just does a wrist flip up at the basket at the end. And how that goes in, I don't know. It's pretty to watch. I don't know anybody else that can do it. He does it regularly. And now... Down 12, Cook's got the ball. He's got the ball to Pedro. He's at the free throw line. He's got Olsen on him. Gets the ball to Lang. Lang's going to use his quickness, try to get inside. They cut him off. Pater, and now Isaiah Moore. He's on the dribble. He's got Burton on him, trying to get inside. And he runs right over the top of Olsen. That's an easy one. Player control foul. Nice job by Jake Olsen to take that charge. Isaiah going to the key. He's kind of out of control. Coach from Carroll can't even get up and argue a block charge call. That one was so obvious. And it's going to be the second foul on Isaiah. And they're going to mop up the floor here. And we're going to see some full court pressure by the Saints. They get the ball into Burton. And the pressure is just going to fade right back in. Around the key is in the front court. That's Burton now. He's at the center circle on the dribble. Cook's on him. A couple dribbles trying to make Cook go for it so he can go around him. Says he's going to go to the right-hand side. No, he's still just going to dribble it. Now he's going to go left. Now he goes right. Nice little move. Burton's inside. He's got a little shot under the basket. Up and in. Javon Burton. What a pretty shot that one was. And now it's 81-67 with 4:42 to play. Getting the call to Lang in the corner. He puts up a three-pointer. It's no good. Burton's got the rebound. Moore snick around the backside. Slapped it out of his hands, but it went out of bounds. It's going to stay with the Argos. Wiping up the floor again. Every time they're down on either end of the floor, there's somebody laying on it. These players are putting a lot of effort into this, and who can blame them? It's the semifinals of the Frontier Conference Championships. And here comes Burton in the front court. He's on the dribble, goes right side. Reed. Little spin move. Trying to get him around Cook. That's not going to happen. Has to get rid of the ball. Almost stolen by Muhammad, and they're going to travel. Good defense there that time by the Saints as they force a travel out of Reed. Reed says, where was the foul? And I think the referee's got it right that time. Just good defense. 4:20 to play. And they get the ball inside to Muhammad. He isn't going to waste any time getting the front court. He's going to stop and pop one at the head of the key. Three-pointer on the way. No good. Rebound comes off. Two CMR grads vying for it. Olsen to Carrington. Olsen gets it. And he gets the ball in the hands of Harris Williams. He's at the head of the key. Moore's on him right there in the center circle. On the dribble. On the dribble. Jab step. He gets tripped. Still comes out of the basketball. No. Cook's got it. And they're going to get the ball into Muhammad. Muhammad's going to have a layup. They're just going to let him have it. And now it's a 12-point lead. And Harris Williams got the ball. He's got Moore on him. On the dribble as he brings across the half-court line. They're going to pressure him the whole way. And he blows right by him. He's in the paint. They're going to get a foul on Moore. And that's going to send Harris Williams to the free throw line. And everything's two shots now because that's the 10th foul on the Saints. So Damian, he's going to go to the free throw line again. He's 10 for 11 from that line. He's got 26 in the ballgame. Senior out of Tacoma, Washington. All conference last year for the Argos. He definitely will be again this year. Free throw's on the way. Good. Not the guy you want to foul. And he knows how to absorb punishment. I mean, that time he had Moore on his heel and he just slowed down. Moore couldn't hit the brakes fast enough, ran into him. That's just the first foul of the ballgame on Kendall. That one's good as well with the free throw line. And now it's a 14-point lead. Ties the largest lead of the ballgame by the Argos. Far side. That's going to be Muhammad to Cook at the head of the key. Cook, he's going to take his way in the paint. Little spin move inside. And he's up and under. Beautiful shot by Andrew Cook. And now there's full court pressure. Damian Williams. Harris Williams with the ball. Working up the right-hand side. They're going to try to double him up. He gets the ball to inside to Olsen. Olsen's got a dunk, but he misses it, but he's fouled. Jake went for the dunk, got hammered. He's going to go to the free throw line and shoot a couple. That's what you do when they try to trap you out there in the corner. And with that, we're going to have a timeout. And it was 3:18 to play here in the ballgame. Saints up, or excuse me, Argos up 85-71. We're going to take a break. We'll take a break for a full minute. We'll be back. KQDI, 1450 AM.
We invite you to stay at one of the newest hotels in Great Falls. Warm, friendly atmosphere, and a friendly staff that's ready to assist you in your every need. When you check in, this is the kind of room you will receive, clean and comfortable, where you get wonderful breakfast and how about a nice glass of wine upon your check-in. Easy check-in with your professional team to assist you. Make your next reservation at the Gibson, downtown Great Falls.
Paul's Cleaner and Laundry Center is your must-stop to get those items clean and looking new again. If you're tired of doing laundry, then don't. Paul's Cleaner and Laundry Service can take care of it. If you'd like to do your own wash, well, you can at Paul's Cleaner and Laundry Center. And don't forget, they have free Wi-Fi, so you can check out your Facebook post while you wait. Paul's Cleaner and Laundry is a complete dry cleaning bundle drop-off and coin-operated machine facility. They are helping the Argo stay fresh and clean all season long. It's Paul's Cleaner and Laundry Center, open daily, 8 a.m. to 9 p.m. with attendance on duty.
Also on the line is Jake Olson. He's a senior out of CMR. His first free throws up and it's good. Jake, he's playing another good ball game for Coach Isaacson. He's 2 for 2 for the free throw line. Now he's 3 for 3. And now up down 14. Here comes the Saints, and Olson steps in front of there. Swats the ball into the scoring bench over there. You know, as many times that ball ends up over here on the media bench, and finally, that's the first time those guys have had to duck all day. And with that, as long as they're busy ducking over there, we're going to take a timeout and talk about some things. Still 3:14 to play. Argos 85, Saints 71. And we're going to take another full minute break. We'll be back. KQDI, 1450 AM.
Are you ready to unleash your awesome? Then you need 8-gig all-fiber internet from TDS. You'll have the powerful internet you need to stream, game, learn, and work today, and be prepared to take on anything new you can dream up tomorrow. Imagine internet you'll never outgrow. Get 8-gig all-fiber internet from TDS and embrace infinite possibility.
Montana has one of the highest suicide rates in the United States.
Suicide impacts people of all ages, genders, and ethnicities.
On average, 300 Montanans die each year by suicide.
Our best chance of stopping suicide is to stop the stigma.
It's time to talk openly and honestly about mental health issues.
Together, let's take the pledge to be allies against suicide.
Let's talk about it.
Let's talk about it.
Let's talk about it.
It's down to crunch time here at the Four Seasons. Argos have a 14-point lead, 3:14 to play. And the Saints have the ball. Isaiah Moore to throw it in from the far side. He's got Vining in front of him. And they're going to try to send Lang across the middle. That's not going to happen, so they're going to go Cook. He's at the three-point line with Currington on him. Good defense by Currington. Cuts him off. Moore's got a three-pointer on the way. Olsen fouled him. Not a good foul by Jake. That's going to be worth 3 free throws, and Jake didn't need the foul. Shot missed. Jake running at the shooter. Picks up his 3rd foul. They don't need him in foul trouble. And with free throw line, is going to be Kendall Moore. Kendall, he's 3 for 4 from that free throw line right now. And now he's 4 for 5. Got Currington, or excuse me, over there waiting to come on is going to be Hosea Carissima, but he's going to have to wait for 2 more. That's right, this is a 3-point. He's got to wait 1 more free throw. He may not be coming in for more. Who misses the front one? Second one off the front of the rim, and now Carissima comes on, and Cook goes to the bench. And 1 more free throw coming for Kendall Moore. And the junior puts this one on the way. He got 2 out of 3. And now it's a 12-point game with 3:08 to play. Full court pressure by the Saints. Have trouble getting the ball in. Sam Vining has to call timeout. Good defense by Carroll. They weren't going to let that inbounds pass in. And so with 85-73 and 3:08 to play, we're going to take a timeout. And it's only going to be a 30-second timeout.
So how exactly is Northwestern Energy delivering a bright future?
By making sure your lights come on every day.
And providing new ways to help you save.
By adding critical infrastructure
that allows our communities to grow.
By dedicating time and resources that ensure our energy's reliability.
And decreasing our emissions until we reach net zero.
It's your future and all of ours.
So we won't stop working
until it's as bright as it can be.
Three wrestlers on the floor right now. Vining to throw it in. He's got Currington or Olsen to get it to. And he goes instead over the corner to Reed. Reed tries to dribble through the trouble. That's a bad idea. Stolen by Moore. Going to have a three-point shot put up over there. That's going to be Muhammad. And now they got the lead down to 10. He can't dribble through those double teams. Now we're going to have a push-off foul. And they're going to call that on Harris Williams. That's going to be his fourth. And they're going to give the ball right over the Saints. Argo's doing everything he can to hand this game right back over to Carroll. It's a player control foul, so it's not going to be a shooting foul. It will be Carroll ball on the sideline. And with that, Coach Lundgren, he wants another timeout. So at the 2:54 mark with an 85-75 score. Let's go ahead and take that break with him.
Some places try to get away with skimming a little off the top. Not at my joint. Godfather's Pizza doesn't cut any corners. Our dough is freshly made every day. We don't sprinkle on a little cheese. We pile on 100% real mozzarella, and we ain't chintzy with the toppings neither. Every pizza is loaded with the highest quality meat and fresh veggies. And nobody, I mean nobody, can compete with our specialty pies like taco, humble pie, classic combo. Don't settle for skimpy. Get the real deal at Godfather's Pizza.
And it's going to be Saints ball right over there in front of their bench. To throw it in, they're down 10, 2:54 to play to make up that difference. Throwing the ball in over there is going to be Lang. And they get the ball, no, not to Muhammad. They're going to have to go down to Kendall Moore. He goes baseline, shots up there, layup up and good. The Argos didn't make him use up any clock at all to get those 2 points. You get the ball inside, it's to Olsen. Olsen takes one dribble, gives the ball to Reed. Reed on the dribble now, bringing the front court. They're going to double him up. They're only up 8. And he got Sam Vining clear down the corner. He's going to launch his three from there. He's been missing all day. Missed another one. Everywhere on the court, he's making it except for right there, and that's generally his best shot. And here they come in the front court. Lang, he's got the dribble, right-hand side. That's Cook. Cook spin move inside, and he's going up against Harris Williams. Harris Williams can't do anything. He's got 4 fouls. Muhammad's going to launch a three from the corner. That's no good. Carrington skies. He gets the rebounds, and Cook drug him to the floor. No, they're going to call a travel. Andrew Crick driving right down to the floor. That would have been Andrew's 5th foul. Possession arrow stays down here on this end of the floor. Moore's going to throw it in. They're down 8, 2:16 to play. Carroll caught a break that time. As they're going to try to run Lang through the top, and they get Moore, or Cook. He's got a 3-pointer on the way. It's no good. Rebound comes off. Carrington and Vining fighting for it. They both lose it. Comes off to Moore instead. He goes baseline. Shots up and good. They're blowing it. They should have had that rebound. Instead, they fought between two guys to get the ball to Reed. Reed's going to dribble it up the floor, try to go between three guys. Fortunately, to get it to Carrington. Carrington is going to get fouled. It's going to be against Isaiah Moore. They're still up 6 with a minute 56 to play. Argos are making this much closer than it needs to be. They're struggling against that press, sending Carrington to the free throw line to shoot 2. And Burton wants on there, but he's going to have to wait for at least 1 free throw at the free throw line. Caleb Carrington, he's a senior. All 3 of these CMR players out there are seniors. Free throw, he misses it. Everything they can do to let them back in the game, they're doing it. Turnovers, missed free throws. And now there's going to be a timeout. It's going to be a full timeout with the Saints talk about things. And with that, we'll take that break with them. Minute 56 to play. Argos up 6. We'll be back. KQDI, 1450 AM.
Montana. The last best place. And we believe the best state to do business. Like many of our clients, Farmers Union Insurance was born and raised in Montana. We started as a couple of farmers agreeing on their good word to insure each other. More than 100 years later, and our foundation is the same, our word is still our promise. Providing protection when it's needed most. With our local claims adjusters and Montana roots, we bring peace of mind that can only be offered by us, the largest mutual insurance company domiciled in Montana. We are committed to you and believe in the true value of buying local. So come see us. Our agents live where you live.
Here they come.
All right, give it to me.
Okay, I want a quarter pounder with cheese and no onions.
6-piece McNuggets.
And extra pickles.
And can I get medium fries?
Ooh, an Oreo McFlurry.
Make that too.
Okay, two McFlurries.
When everyone wants something special, order ahead in the app to save time.
And they got the lanes filled. And Caleb got the ball. CMR grabs, got that one on the way. That one's good. And now it's 7 points. And here comes Moore. They're going to be in a hurry to get the ball in the front court. The Argos can't be giving up quick baskets down here. They get the ball to Moore. He's on the baseline. Olsen's on him. Going to put up a three-pointer. It's good. These guys are just absolutely amazing. They need baskets, and they're getting them. And now they get the ball inside to Burton in the corner. Burton gets the ball to Reed, and Reed's going to be fouled by Moore. Send Reed down to the free throw line. Still a minute 37 to play. It's down to a four-point game now. What big shots these guys are hitting. I mean, the game's on the line. They're deep in the corner, just nailing threes. Reed's at the free throw line. He's done a fine job there so far tonight. He's 3-for-3. He's a good free throw shooter. Can he keep it going? They're going to need him to. Minute 37 to play, and the Saints are right back in this thing. A while ago, things were looking pretty good if you're an Argo fan. And Jalen Reed, he's a senior. He's at the free throw line. A couple of needed free throws. First one's on the way, and it's good. Ice in his veins. Nice shot by Jalen. And now it's a five-point game. Referee clears the lane. We're ready to play some basketball. Bounces it to Jalen. And the senior takes his couple dribbles. Crowd's a hollering, and it doesn't work. It goes in anyway. And now it's 6 points again. And now they just dribbled the ball inbounds, and the referee didn't catch it. And Moore's in the front court. Now the Isaiah Moore, deep in the corner. That's going to be Lang. He tries to get inside. He can drop it off to Muhammad. Muhammad. I think they're going to call Harris Williams with his fifth foul. He had his hands on him as he went by, and that is. And with a minute 27, best player for the Argos goes to the bench for the game. Harris Williams goes to the bench, and he takes his 28 points with him. He's also their best free throw shooter. Muhammad goes to the line to shoot anywhere to 1-on-1. He needs to make the first to get the second. You got Olsen and Burton underneath the basket in case he misses. And it misses, and they swatted the ball out of there. They knock Olsen right in the hand. They get the ball to Lang. Lang might have got away with a travel. He's got the ball sideline, gets the ball baseline. Baseline Muhammad. Muhammad getting the ball into Cook. Cook's got a layup. It's up and in. And now there's a minute 14 to play, and they're down four. Taking the ball out. It's going to be Carrington. Carrington looking for somebody. Anybody gets it to Burton. Burton gets the ball up here to Vining. Vining gets the ball to Carrington. Carrington in the front court. Dribbling down. He's got a layup on the far end there. Gets the ball swatted. It goes out of bounds with 1 minute left. And now baseline Argos. Milner's in. And going to the bench is going to be Burton. And taking the ball on the baseline will be the Argos, Carrington. He's going to throw it in from down there. He's got them all in the line in front of him, except Milner's over here on the other side of the block. And now he gets in the line as well. Now he goes back out of there. And they're talking with the coach over there. Now they give the ball to Carrington. He swats the ball. Where are they going to go with it? Looking for anybody. Somebody gets them, tries to get the Vining. Ball gets swatted out. Going to go off of Cook. And it's still going to be baseline ball for the Argos as Burton's going to come back on. Carrington goes to the bench. And who's going to throw it in? That's normally Harris Williams' job. He's on the bench with five fouls. And all the Argos are milling around and stepping in. There's going to be Milner. Milner looking to get the ball inside. If he can find it in there, that's not going to happen. Goes all the way over the top to Reed. Reed now, he's on the dribble, working on the right-hand side. And he's going to burn some of that clock up. Are they going to let him do it? They're up by four, 53 seconds on the clock. Nobody's within 10 feet of him. Clock's down. He's got 10 seconds to do something. He's going to go left. Got Cook on him now. He goes in the paint. He's got a shot up in there. And he gets checked. Cook comes out of there with it. And he's going to bring down here. He's 40 seconds. They bring in the front court. You got Olsen on him. Takes it inside. Shots up. It's no good. Isaiah Moore gets the rebound and puts it back up. That's good. Now they're only down by two with 34 seconds left. Saints are coming out of nowhere, folks. I'm telling you. They just won't quit. The Argos are going to have to meet their intensity. They're going to lose this ball game. 34.3 seconds left. We're going to be gone for another minute. KQDI, 1450 AM.
For more than 85 years,
D.A. Davidson has strived to build relationships and trust from our first office in Montana to each of our 70 locations spread out coast to coast. We're on the ground and in your neighborhood, combining the values of a local partner with the capabilities of a national institution. We achieve strong outcomes based on mutual success, planning for future generations, and building legacies that endure together.
It's coming down to crunch time. 3 minutes on the clock. Argos had a big lead. 14 points. Now there's 34 seconds on the clock. Their lead's down to two. Milner's going to throw the ball in from the baseline there. Full court pressure by the Saints. As they're going to try to free up Vining. Vining goes his way through there, and he comes over here to Reed. Reed, they're going to trap him in there. Tries to put the ball on the floor. They knock the ball out there. Now they've got Reed, and they're on the foul. They're going to call a foul. No, they're not. He got talked out of it. They're going to call a jump ball, and the Saints have the arrow. All over Reed, right here in front of me. And the Saints, I think they're out of timeouts. They got 28 seconds. They're down by two. And they got the ball. Isaiah Moore to throw it in. He's got Vining right in front of him. And they'll look for Cook. If you look for anybody but Cook, I don't know, Moore. He's the leading scorer for him right now. Going to try to set a pick to free him up. He's going to shoot right over the top of Reed. That one's on the way. It's no good. They swat the ball out of there. Coming out of the rebound is going to be the Saints. And the far side, Lang. Lang to Moore. They have the key. He's going to launch another three. That one's partially checked. Coming out of there with it's going to be Olsen. And are they going to call a foul on Olsen? Lang's on the ground. The foul should be called on Lang. And it is. He gets up limping. And with 11 seconds left, Olsen's going to go down to the far end of the floor. Senior Jake Olsen. He's going to get to shoot two free throws here. He makes them both. The Saints are in trouble. Good defense that time by the Argos. Moore tried to get off a three-point shot. Partially checked. Everybody's flying in there for the rebound. Olsen came out of there with it. Lang whacked him in the arm trying to get it out of there. And the senior's at the free throw line, and he's going to make that one. Now they're up three. Jake's at the free throw line. He's 4 for 4 from there right now in this ballgame. He makes this one. Just get out of the way. Don't foul. That should be what Coach Isaacs is saying. This one's on the way, and it is good. And now it's 90 to 86. And here comes Moore flying on the floor. Get out of his way. Get out of his way. He's going to get a layup. It's up, and it's good. 6.8 seconds left to go in the ballgame. And the Argos have the ball, try to get the ball inside, and they do. And over the corner, Milner's got it. He's going to get fouled with 5 seconds. Or not. Isaacson is going to call a timeout. There was no foul. Still 5 seconds of the game. Argos are up by two. We're going to take a timeout. Has anybody got a full timeout left? I'm not sure. We're going to take a minute. We'll be back. KQDI, 1450 AM. If someone would have told me that this game was going to be better than the last game, I'd have said, no way. Tech won that game by 1 point over Western when Western missed a shot right at the buzzer. And now this game comes down. It's a two-point game, 5 seconds left. Argos have the lead. Argos have the ball. They're going to have to get it inbounds, which has proved to be tricky for them against this press that the Saints put on. And they're going to be over there on the sideline. It's going to be Milner to throw it in. And they're going to send Reed down the floor. And Reed's going to have a layup. He might have just well done. Oh, he gets fouled. He gets hammered by Cook. And they stand up there glaring at each other. It was a good foul. It was a hard foul. It's going to be Cook's fifth. He's out of the ball game. Settle down, Jalen. He was jumping up there. He hurt his finger on the rim as Cook came in there and blasted him. It was a hard foul. You'd expect that at this stage of the game. They're not going to allow a dunk. And now here comes the ball in with 3 seconds still going in the ball game. And they're going to send Cook to the sideline with his fifth foul. The referee, they won't put it up on the scoreboard up there, but I'm sure it's his fifth. And they're going to have a timeout called. Neither team has any timeouts left. And what are they looking at here? Referees are over talking to the bench. And we never have privy to what they're talking about. They do put Pedro on the floor, and they haven't shown Cook out yet, nor have they put the deal up on the board. They're all standing over there, sitting over there at five, and there they got the five on the board. He's officially out of the ballgame. So the two best players in the games, the stars for both teams, are on the bench. Harris Williams has been sitting for the last couple minutes for the Argos, and now Cook goes to the bench for the Saints. And coming down here, he's going to have two free throws. It's going to be Jalen Reed. And 3 seconds to go in the ballgame. This game is not over, folks. 3 seconds is a long time. Reed goes in, going to shoot the dunk. He should have just ran to the corner and just ran that timeout. Instead, they set themselves up to where they need to make free throws again. They're not coming out of the huddle over there. I'm not sure what's going on. The referees are saying, we got to play basketball, fellas. Come on. And here they come out on the floor, and Reed's going to stand there all by himself. I think they have a technical foul that was called. Yep, it was. A technical foul against Carroll, so Reed's going to get to shoot actually four free throws here. This should be able to ice the game with 3 seconds left. He hasn't missed a free throw the whole game, still hasn't. And now it's a three-point lead. He makes this one be just about impossible for Carroll to come back and win. And it's up and it's good. So now it's a four-point lead. I got to get the pull that Rocky Erickson has. He's got the referee over there explaining that whole thing to him. Maybe he'll stop here at my station and he goes by. Ah, not going to happen. Oh, wait a minute. Timeout. Now we're going to go down. It must have been a double technical because Lang's going to shoot free throws on the other end. And the first one's good. Well, if that was a technical against Reed, I think that would have about been his fifth foul, but he's only got four up there on the... Well, I'm sure I'm wrong. Free throw's good. Now it's back to a two-point lead. And now we're going to get back to the free throws. Wait. What are they doing here? They're going to give the ball to Carroll? Whatever happened to the foul on the shot? I think they're giving the ball to the wrong team. Well, I have nothing to say about it. They get the ball into Lang. Lang's going to launch one from the head of the key. This goes in. Carroll's win, and it does. Pandemonium as the Saints come back and win this basketball game. Reed was down there dunking. And they must have called the technical on Reed is all I can figure. Either way you look at it, final score, Saints 93, Argos 92. The Saints go on and the Argos season is over. And the players are upset with the referees. Coaches are upset trying to get them away from them. It's not a pretty sight right now. This isn't all about sportsmanship right now. Saints win, Argos lose. 93-92. Let's go ahead and take a break for a couple minutes. I'll do the scoring here, and then we'll come back with a wrap-up of this ballgame. Glenn Limer with the call. KQDI, 1450 AM. Well, the Carroll College Saints, they needed a miracle, and they got it. The Argos did every possible thing they could do to lose that ball game. They had a 14-point lead with about 3 minutes to go. Turnovers, missed free throws, technical fouls, just missed shots, everything it took. And on the other hand, the Saints came down, and they made every single shot they took. Several three-pointers there, including the last one of the buzzer, put in by James Lang. He was out there pretty close to halfway, about halfway between the three-point line and the half-court line, and he drained the three. They win by one. The season is over for the Great Falls University of Providence Argos. And with that loss, we can say goodbye to the following seniors. Caleb Currington, he's all done. Jalen Reed, he's done. Freddie Brown III, he's done. Harris Williams, Davis Harris Williams, he's all finished up now. And Eric Milner, he was a senior out there. Then we get down here, Javon Burton was a senior. Sam Vining was a senior. Jake Olson, senior. So they loaded with seniors, and all those guys, their careers are done. And they lose by 1 point to the Saints in the semifinal on a miracle comeback by the Saints. Great shooting by the Saints, but also set up by some misplay by the Argos. And with that, let's go ahead and do the count for the end of the game. We'll start with Carroll. Kendall Moore, he led all scorers. He had 29 points in the ballgame. 21 points were put in by Andrew Cook. 19 points by James Lang. Shahid Muhammad had 4. Isaiah Moore had 4. 1 point by Derek Kramer. Murat Guzlacic, he had 2. And 1 point was put in by Josiah Charisma. And for the Great Falls Providence Argos, Damian Harris-Williams.